Infinity and Me, written by Kate Hosford, illustrations by Gabby Sietkowska. The night I got my new red shoes, I couldn't wait to wear them to school. I was too excited to sleep, so I went outside and sat on the lawn. When I looked up, I shivered. The sky seemed so huge and cold. How many stars were there in the sky? A million? A billion? Maybe the number was as big as infinity. I started to feel very, very small. How could I even think about something as big as infinity? At school the next day, I asked my friend Charlie how he imagines infinity. "That's easy, Uma," he said. "It's a giant number that keeps growing bigger and bigger forever. I thought about trying to write that number down. Even if I live forever, I would never finish." I went to get ice cream after school with my best friend Samantha. "Sam," I asked her, "when you think about infinity, what do you see?" "I see the infinity symbol," she said. "It looks like an eight that fell over and took a nap. If it were a racetrack, I could drive around it forever." Samantha made me feel a little better. Writing that symbol wouldn't take long at all. I traced a napping eight in the dirt with my shoe. Before school the next day, I asked Grandma how she imagines infinity. She smiled at me and said, "I like to think about my family, about a family. First, you have the great-grandparents, then the grandparents, parents, children, grandchildren, great-grandchildren. It could go on forever." I couldn't really imagine that many people in one family, but I did realize something. It was hard to talk about infinity without talking about forever. I also realized something else. Not one person had noticed my new red shoes. Not even Grandma, who usually notices everything. I looked down to make sure they were still shiny. Then I started to wonder, what would I like to do forever? At first, I thought that I might like to have recess forever. But if there's no school before recess, and no school after recess, is it really recess anymore? Maybe I'd like to be eight forever. But I don't know if Samantha would still want to be my best friend when she was 85 and I was still eight. Maybe I could lick an ice cream cone forever? But what if my tongue started to hurt? Actually, my head was starting to hurt from all these thoughts. When I went to the lunchroom, I asked our cook, Mr. Mancini, how he imagined infinity. He held up a noodle. "How many times do you think you could cut this in half?" he asked. "Cut it in half 6 times, but then I got too small and I was afraid I might cut my finger instead of the noodle." "In your mind," Mr. Mancini said, "could you cut that tiny piece of noodle in half forever?" I wonder. I asked Ms. Reed, our music teacher, about infinity and wished I hadn't. "Picture music that goes in a circle," she said. "The notes would lead us around and around, and the music would be endless." It was starting to think that my questions about infinity might be endless. It was time for me and my red shoes to go home. For dinner, Grandma made my favorite meal, butter chicken and rice. As she mixed the spices, she looked at me and said, "Well, I meant to tell you this morning that those are the most beautiful shoes I've ever seen." I didn't hear the rest of what Grandma said. I was too busy smiling. Right then I knew my love for her was as big as infinity. That night, I asked her if she would like to look at the stars with me. Snuggled up next to Grandma, the sky didn't seem so huge and cold anymore. Now it was more like a sparkly blanket covering us both. Author's note. Can you remember when you first started thinking about infinity? Perhaps it was when you first started wondering about the biggest number that exists. Or maybe you and a friend had a conversation like this. "I know the names of 100 dinosaurs." "Oh yeah? Well, I know the names of infinity dinosaurs." Children quickly learn the power of infinity, especially when they are trying to impress their friends. People thousands of years ago also knew the power of infinity. Such a limitless idea made them uneasy. In 1655, the mathematician John Wallis started using the symbol like an 8 to stand for infinity. This napping 8 is called a lemniscate. It made the idea easier to write, but not much easier to imagine. After I had children, I was interested to hear what they had to say about infinity. I also talked to other children in kindergarten through second grade about this concept. Here are some of the things they said. Infinity is a made-up number that is supposed to be the last number, but it isn't really the last number, because numbers go on and on. If you start counting to infinity, you will die, and you will still be counting. It's an expression that means a number that goes on forever. A number that no one can believe. Infinity is no one can count it. All the responses were so smart and thoughtful. These children understood that infinity is an idea that can also act as a number. They also understood that infinity doesn't behave the same way other numbers do. For instance, you can add to infinity or subtract from it, and it will still be infinity. Which, as one student said, is hard to believe. The children I interviewed also thought about infinity in other creative ways. Infinity is when you ask what's outside the galaxy, and then outside of that, and on and on. Infinity is on Earth because new people keep being born. Infinity is a journey around the Earth on a plane that goes forever. What is the idea of infinity? Why is the idea of infinity so important? People who study math, astronomy, physics, philosophy, and religion all use it in different ways. Infinity helps us think about questions like, what is the size of the universe? Or how many points are on a line? Or can you love someone? Can your love for someone last forever? In this book, Uma listens to everyone else's definition of infinity. Then she comes up with one that is right for her. My challenge to you is to find your own way to imagine this idea. How many ways are there to imagine infinity? An infinite number. Just close the book and begin.